Hey, hey, y'all, it's your girl Erica Vane back again with another entertainment television breakdown. And in this video, I am talking about the series Run the World, and specifically, should Whitney tell her fiance Ola that she cheated? Let's talk about it. Okay, so I'm going to tell y'all what my honest thoughts and opinions are in this matter, but y'all don't get to judge me, okay? You don't get to judge me for what I'm about to say. This is a case-by-case basis. In regular circumstances, I'm 100% for being completely honest, open, and transparent, and moving forward, having the tough conversations and all that jazz. But something in my spirit is telling me that she should not tell Ola, y'all. Oh, actually, the only reason why I am partly, like, I have like 10-20% feeling like she should tell Ola, because she actually recorded herself in a therapy session in last episode admitting to actually doing it. So I feel like the only reason why I would see her wanting, or why I would want her to actually tell Ola, is if she has not deleted that recording and somehow he's going to come across it and find out that way. That would be the complete worst way for him to find out that she cheated on him. But if she destroys that recording and that's nowhere to be found, and it doesn't become a plot point or a device later on down the line to out her, then I think that she needs to take this to the grave. Last episode, we got a lot of perspective from each of the girls, but in particular with Whitney, I got a clear understanding on who she is, what motivates her, what also are her insecurities and things like that. And I really have been wanting that this entire time. I couldn't for the life of me figure out why in the heck she was just having so much trouble walking into this marriage with Ola, why she was just trying to try any and everything. Now all of a sudden she wants to hop on community peen, and she wants to smoke cigarettes, and she just wants to do all the things, and I could not figure out for the life of me why. But when they go to the therapy sessions, then we actually get perspective on the why behind it, and it makes sense. She is envious of her friend Renee. She's envious and resentful of Renee for being such a free spirit, for being so confident in her own skin, and for being selfish enough to choose herself and validate herself and not look to others to do that. And that's something that Whitney has done her whole life and has not been able to grow out of, has not been able to shift out of. And she feels very much so caged in, which is part of the reason why she even cheated on Ola to begin with. She slept with the dude Chris because she just had never done it before. And again, I've made videos about this talking about how I just felt like it was trite, honestly, for her to just be doing things just for the sake of doing them. But now we understand that she's doing them for a greater need to express herself, to validate herself. But some of the choices that she has made, such as cheating on Ola, did not actually help, because come to find out, she really do love Ola. She's just very scared of further committing to the life that she's created for herself, because she's already finding herself regretting and feeling like she's lacking for all of the decisions that she's made thus far. So I think that she believes that if she marries Ola, or she's getting cold feet, because if she marries Ola, that's going to be another decision that she committed to do right, or be the good girl, or, you know, maintain this perfect persona. And she's not 100% sure that it's even right for her. Now, what I do love, and now I can give her at least a little bit more grace while I'm talking about it, is she doesn't know if it's going to be right for her, but she also doesn't know if it's going to be wrong for her. So she's operating in a very interesting space, because like I said, I really do believe that she does love Ola. I think that she does love certain aspects of her life. She just wants a little bit more freedom in there as well, to be able to express herself and honestly probably truly drop in and get to know herself. Because I really believe that Whitney, because she has been performing for so much of her life and trying to be perfect for so much of her life, I believe that she doesn't even know herself on a deep level yet. But I said all of that to say, these are the reasons why I don't think that she should tell Ola, because one, I don't think that she's going to sleep with anybody else. Like, I think that she got it out of her system. She feels terribly guilty about it. And ultimately, she realizes that it was a mistake, not just because she's going to get caught, but because she literally tried this thing and she didn't really want to do it. She enjoyed it for the moment, in reference to what it was, but she didn't enjoy the, like, sharing herself with somebody random and all of that. So I don't think it would be a problem that persists. Now, if she still was going to go through with this wedding, this is why I'm saying she shouldn't tell Ola. Now, if she decides that she don't want to go through with it, then by all means, sis, go ahead, hurt feelings and let it rip. But I think that it would do more harm than good to disclose this to him. And I know y'all, that sounds raggedy and toxic AF, but sometimes when it comes to situations like this, sometimes it's not even about you being honest with the other person. It's like that honesty is taking the weight and the guilt off of you and then putting a burden on them. If she is going to walk into this marriage and be 100% committed and do everything that she has to do and this will never happen again, I'm all for her not saying anything to Ola and going on and being happy. Now, the caveat is that she has to get to a point where she's actually cool with the decisions that she makes and enjoying the decisions that she's making and walking into this marriage happily. Now, if you ain't walking into this marriage happily now, sis, don't drag this man through the mud or continue to lead him on, basically, because you still want to go out and explore. If you have gotten it out your system, Whitney, if you're going to explore getting to know yourself in other ways, but you could do so in a committed relationship with someone who is madly in love with you, who you seem to also be in love with, maybe not as much, but definitely still in love with, then by all means, do not say nothing. But if you still ain't sure about Ola, if you still ain't sure about this marriage, not only you could still not tell him, but I would probably tell him, but you should also walk away from the relationship and give yourself time and space to figure out what the hell you're going to do next with your life and what direction you need to be going in. Because at this point, her continuing to keep up the pace that she's at and just running off in knee-jerk reactions and doing all types of things, it's not going to work. She needs a full stop. She needs to pull up that emergency brake, stop everything, reassess, and then proceed to drive forward. But y'all, those are my thoughts around the question, should Whitney tell Ola that she cheated? Let me know what you think in the comment section down below. What do you think about Whitney and Ola's relationship? Do you think that she should reveal the truth? Do you think that she actually will step out on him again? Tell me all that and more in the comment section down below. If you're new here, I'm Erica Vane, and I break down all the hottest television shows. In addition to cultivating an amazing community of television lovers like yourself, and we have dope ass conversations in the comment section, so you should really join the tribe and hit subscribe so that you can be a part of the conversation, be one of our friends, and get in on it and never miss a video when I upload. If you miss any of my Run the World coverage, I have my All About Run the World playlist link for you right here, and you can catch up on all of those videos. And if you're looking for something else to watch because you love Run the World but you want something else, sis, I got two suggestions for you that'll be perfect. Get into it, and I'll see you in my next one. Bye.